So emotions, I think, are not just jolts of electricity, but they involve thoughts about what's happening to us, what's good and bad, and fear connects us to the bad. It's the thought that there's terrible bad stuff out there and we're not entirely in control of warding it off.
The thought is freedom from fear.
Dear Martha Nussbaum, is fear a threat to democracy?
So fear has been something that philosophers have talked about ever since the Greeks, mm-hmm. and it's always been thought to be a terrible problem for democracy. It was known very well that fear was an emotion that was particularly susceptible to demagogic manipulation, and they were very worried about that. The Thucydides, the historian, talks about how the Athenians voted to put to death a whole bunch of rebellious colonists because a demagogue had whipped them up into a state of fear. And then someone else went through the analysis, and then they decided, well, actually, that was stupid. So it's always been a problem, and I think it probably was at its height recently during the Great Depression.
When men become so prideful that they believe their destiny is to rewrite the eternal law of God, it's time for their fellow citizens to rise up in their wrath.
And then there was a kind of ebb back. But now, well, you know, I see my students have this terrible sense that it's like the last days of civilization and that we must be terrified that this is unprecedented. And, you know, they don't even want to talk to students who might have voted for Trump. They think that they must be monsters. And I think this is really bad. Instead of talking and sitting down and trying to figure out how we can get together and solve this problem, they just turn away, and they're stampeded by fear. It's not that that no fears are rational. I think that it's rational to fear your own death or to fear harm to your family. But we have to ask ourselves, before we get stampeded and run off in some direction, we have to ask, what do we really have reason to fear? Roosevelt once said, we have nothing to fear but fear itself.
Let me assert my firm belief that the only thing we have to fear is fear itself. Nameless, unreasoning, unjustified terror.
That was actually not very precise, because in that era we had tremendous things that it was reasonable to fear. Nazism, economic unrest, and so on. So better, I think, was President Obama when he said, democracy may buckle if we give way to fear. So it's the giving way, the not pausing to examine it and sort it out.